In 2016, Belgian cyclist Femke van der Drescher made sporting history for a surprising reason. It wasn't for her success in the cyclocross championships, becoming Belgian champion in her age group. Instead, she was the first cyclist ever sanctioned by the UCI for mechanical doping. Mechanical doping is a form of cheating, using technology to get an unfair advantage. And in this case, a bicycle was found with a motor hidden inside. And this was a big deal. The first time in cycling history where evidence of technological fraud was found. Cycling has faced more than its fair share of sporting scandals, but the next controversy might not come about because of modified equipment, but because of modified genes. To understand this, we have to understand what gene therapy is and how scientists created what's been called Schwarzenegger mice. Gene therapy is a process to treat disease through the genetic modification of cells. The basic idea behind gene therapy is to fix a genetic problem at the source. What can happen is that a gene could have a mutation that leads to disease. So the idea behind gene therapy is to replace that gene with a copy without the mutation and that functions correctly. This isn't just a theory or something that might happen in the future. There are gene therapies being used right now. The first FDA-approved gene therapy drugs were approved in 2017, including one to treat acute lymphoblastic leukemia. And it does this by using the body's own T cells to fight the cancer. Do you remember bubble boy disease? The extremely rare genetic condition that causes children to have extremely limited immune systems. This condition, known as severe combined immunodeficiency, has been treated with experimental gene therapy treatments and with significant success, so much so that children have been able to live fairly normal lives. With the technology and benefits understood, there's a potential for gene therapy to be used not just to fight diseases, but to benefit athletes in something known as gene doping. To understand how gene therapy could be used by athletes, I want to introduce you to marathon mice and Schwarzenegger mice. In 2004, scientists at Howard Hughes Medical Institute enhanced the function of a single protein, allowing mice to have altered muscle composition, giving them physical endurance to run twice as far as normal mice. This treatment could be used to support patients with debilitating illnesses that limits their ability to exercise, but of course has the potential to be used by athletes. And it's not just running. In 2007, researchers at the University of Pennsylvania developed a gene transfer technology where they injected normal mice with a virus containing the gene for insulin growth factor 1, a protein which makes muscle fibers grow. And the result was nicknamed super mice or Schwarzenegger mice with enormous muscles and significant strength into old age. While there haven't been proven cases of gene doping in humans, it is something that the sporting bodies are taking seriously. The World Anti-Doping Agency has proactively banned it and has invested in ways to detect it. There's enormous potential for gene therapy and the technology in the future. Researchers such as Professor Nigel McMillan at Griffith University are exploring how this technology can be used for cancer treatment.
So gene therapy is now a reality and we can treat many serious illnesses, but this gene replacement therapy, kind of like swapping out the entire engine in your car, will be replaced with CRISPR technology. With CRISPR, we only replace the broken bits in your engine or your genome while it's still running. So with this new technology, we will now be able to treat many more illnesses, including cancers. So watch this space.
As an example for using gene therapy technology, we can look for how it's been used to cure cervical cancer. The cancer is driven by a virus with a mutant gene. With enhanced tools to do the gene editing, notably CRISPR, a technology which allows the precise and specific editing of the DNA sequence, scientists target this gene and allow the healthy genes to remain. And the trials have been highly positive, with 100% survival and success rate in animal trials, a world first using CRISPR gene editing therapy. And these trials will move to humans in the coming years.